Hello everybody, this is Not a Crypto Expert chiming in with another video, and in today's video I wanted to go over one of the biggest benefits that I see with cryptocurrency and Bitcoin over traditional finance. But before I get into the topic of conversation for today, I would like to ask that you please consider giving me a like, giving me a heart, giving me a thumbs up, giving me a follow, a subscribe, hitting that post bell notification. I'm not going to ask you to share because it seems invasive on my channel. I talk about cryptocurrency and blockchain technology, and I try to keep it entertaining with the beat playing in the background. So on to the topic of conversation for today, which comes to us from cryptopolitan.com, and the title of this article is Bitcoin transfer fee, $367 million moves for a fee of just 63 cents. This article was published on April the 25th, 2020, and today is April the 28th of 2020. The Bitcoin network has again succeeded in transferring BTC worth hundreds of millions of dollars at the cost of only cents. Such a negligible Bitcoin transfer fee is not viable through any other network across the world. On April 24th, BTC, which stands for Bitcoin, amounting to $367 million, was moved at the cost of just 63 cents. This massive transfer joins other past-alike incidents where high values have been transferred at the expense of minor fees through the Bitcoin network. As at press time, the identity of the transfer is still anonymous. The sending and receiving addresses are yet to be singled out. The transfer marks another Bitcoin milestone that would be unfeasible through any other financial network in the world. The movement of such a massive figure would cost significantly higher than 63 cents through any other platform. The use of digital currencies such as Bitcoin or any other is quite economical since there are no middlemen or central authorities that are looking to benefit from the transfer. With that said, the subject of transaction costs has been a disputed issue in the digital currency sector. Some members of the cryptocurrency community argue that 63 cent Bitcoin transfer fee is still a significant amount for the many possible applications of virtual currencies. Advocates of other digital currencies are always eager to prompt that Bitcoin fees are cheaper in other networks than Bitcoin transaction fees. However, the fact remains that the Bitcoin network has facilitated the majority of considerable shipments in the digital currency industry. So far, Bitcoin has a higher hash rate than all the other cryptocurrency networks. Besides, it provides the most reliable security to users against network attacks and hackers. Due to these facts, BTC represents the only safest way to move 50,000 Bitcoin without worries and at a low cost. Now, I know that I've done videos regarding how low transaction fees are before, and I will continue to do them just because I want to make sure that people understand that besides the decentralization aspect, besides being able to send anybody in the world currency, the fact that you pay little to nothing for the fee itself is one of the things that I love about cryptocurrency and Bitcoin itself. Now, I know with my banking app, I can send money to most people as long as they have a banking app that has the Zelle, and it's generally free. At least I don't think that I've had to spend anything for a Zelle transaction. However, I have had to send money to people that were not a part of the Zelle network, and I mean, it was a lot more than 63 cents, and that was like through my bank. You know, if you want to send something to somebody via PayPal or Western Union or MoneyGram or however you want to send it, I guarantee you that you're spending more than 63 cents for any transaction, unless, like I said, it's a part of like Zelle. I'm not too familiar with Cash App. I've used it maybe twice since it's been out, and I don't even know. Well, since I've had it, I can't say how long it's been out, but to me, it's just I would much rather just send somebody crypto to an address. The anonymity part is granted, you can always, there are ways to find out who conducted a transaction on a public blockchain, but I mean, it's not like there's a sent and received on there as far as like the person's name. It would take some work, but I'm getting sidetracked. I want to get back on the fact that 63 cents, less than a double cheeseburger from McDonald's with no onions, to send over $300 million. Just think about that, folks. And think about what the banks would do if they were no longer collecting these insane fees that they've been charging us for decades. So, with that being said, folks, don't forget to hit that like button, that heart button, that thumbs up button, that follow, that subscribe, that post bell notification. I'm not gonna ask you to share because it seems invasive, and I hope that you're having a great morning, great afternoon, and an even better evening.